Hi, I'm Russell Cummings from Strategic Business Development, and I'm the project leader for Horticulture the Next Generation, a HAL-funded project that looks to improve the business skills of Australian horticultural leadership. And want to talk to you today about our online training programs that we're currently offering, so that you get a bit of an understanding of A, what's available, but also how to get the most out of those training programs. So this is a short video. So let's just take you quickly to what courses are available. And I'll just quickly jump to the website, if you'll bear with me. Okay, as you can see here, we have 9 courses for you, ranging from business improvement all the way through to team development. Now, these are courses that are around improving your business skills in various areas. And if you click on the course overview on the webpage, it will give you some more detail around each course, but I'll just quickly take you through them. Business improvement is basically our short strategic planning process. So it's a process where you do a quick plan for your business and end up with a one-page plan. Continuous improvement is all about focusing on lean manufacturing type tools, but applying them into your business and looking to improve efficiency and reduce costs. Marketing and sales is fairly straightforward. It's about developing a business to almost consumer or business to business marketing plan and linking that then to your sales program. Self-confidence is very much focused on you, the individual, and it's about looking to improve your confidence as a manager or an owner in your business, and some great tools in there from Dr. Darrell around those sorts of things. Sales Performance Course by Mike Boyle is an excellent course. If you have a primary responsibility for sales in your organization or you manage a sales team, a great course you do to really lift your skills and get your focus right. Consulting and Facilitation is really designed around improving your presentation skills, those sorts of things. Probably not as relevant as the other courses to horticultural businesses. Leadership Development is really around developing your skills as a leader in your business or your organizational. Personal improvement is about understanding where you want to be personally and then helping you get set some plans for how you're going to get there. And then lastly, the team development one is all about how we develop your team and help them to take your business to where it needs to go. So they're the courses you can pick from. You can pick one of these courses and then you've got till the 30th of March 2015 to complete that. So let's now go back and talk about some tips for actually making sure you get the most value out of each of these courses. And then I'll take you quickly through a typical course structure just so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so how do you get the most out of your training? Well, the important thing is that you need to allocate the time. So if you think you're just going to do it for, you know, half hour every night after work, then think again, because my experience is that we'll still be here in a year's time and you won't have finished it. So make sure you allocate the time. So pretend that the course is a face-to-face course that you have to go to, and block out some time. These are our full mind shop courses, and we may put in some short courses in as well into the offer, but at the moment these are our full mind shop courses, and each course will take you between 1 and 3 days of elapsed time. Because they're very applied and they get you to apply the learning directly to your business. So make sure you break it down to time blocks. My recommendation is that you block out sessions of between 1 to 4 hours where you just say, I'm going to get stuck into this course and do it. If you do that, you will get on a roll because each module builds on the next module, those sorts of things, and you will start to get some real synergy in your training, and you won't be picking up and putting down, and you'll find you'll fly through it. If you don't do this, my experience is then you won't finish the course. Make sure you apply the learning. So all the courses are very applied. So in that, by that I mean that you will be taught a concept or a tool or a process that will then ask you to apply it to your business and work out what it means for you and your business, or what the actions that derive from it for your business are. Now, you can apply it to a meaningful entity. By that I mean you can apply it to your business or to your job, maybe to your personal life, it's one of the personal courses, or to your industry. But it's really important that in the one course that you're relatively consistent throughout the course. So you don't want to be swapping from business to job to personal to industry in the same course, because the modules build on each other and you won't get a flow, a stream of consciousness that flows between different modules. The last thing's really important is that no matter when you start the course, you need to have it finished by March the 30th, 2015. So if you only sign up on March the 23rd, you've got 7 days to power through it. If you sign up now, you get into it. My advice to you is get stuck into the course now. We're very likely to offer other free courses once you've finished this one, but at this stage, it's only one per person. All right, let's look at how we navigate it. So I'll quickly take you back to the site, and we'll have a look at some just what the courses look like and how you navigate your way around. Okay, so here we are back in the MindShop Online website. And I'll take you through and have a look at the self-confidence course that's been put together by Dr. Daryl Cross for us. Now, this course, all the courses are structured in a similar way. So you'll find there's a series of modules. So in Daryl's course, there are 17 modules, including a summary and the course evaluation. So there's a little bit to work through. And this page here shows you what's in each module and tells you whether you complete it or not. Now, you don't have to do the modules in order, although it probably makes sense that you do each module in order, because that's the way that Daryl's constructed it, or whoever's constructed the course has put a logical structure into it. But you can pick and choose if you like. Now, if you click on the module, it will take you through to this sort of page. All the training programs have a similar sort of structure. So there's normally a video. So this one's a 4-minute video, but they're normally less than 10 minutes, taking you through some of the key elements that you need to think about for this particular module. Then there's normally some text and some discussion and some thinking around that particular thing you're looking at. And then there's normally a worksheet that you'll then need to complete. So this one is a simple score. So you put your score on each here, calculate the score to give you a number, and then Daryl's giving you a rating system here, and then ask you some questions on it. Once you've got down the bottom here, you can save it. So don't forget to save it. If you don't save it, it won't be kept at all. So if you haven't completed it, then you hit partial save, and then you can come back to it later. If you have completed the entire worksheet to your satisfaction, then click on complete the save, and it will take you automatically to the next worksheet. You can come back, of course, and change your information later if you want to, but that's where it'll take you through. And then if you do that, it will appear over here as, you know, date completed or whatever. So it will tell you what you've done and what you haven't. All right, so that's a pretty similar structure for most of the courses. At the end, there's a very simple evaluation, so it will take you through some questions a summary, and give you a chance to do an evaluation for us on how you went in the course and how you found it. All right, so that's what the courses look like. They're all got a very similar structure. Okay, well, that's a quick overview of the course, some tips for how to get the most out of them, and then the structure for how the courses are laid out. If you'd like any more information, then please email me at russell@horticulture-nextgeneration.com.au, and happy to help you out. I guess the main thing is, if you've got any questions at all, please don't hesitate to ask. Make sure you register for our online newsletter through the Horticulture Next Generation site to keep up to date with activities like these training programs and those sorts of things. But also participate in our free webinar program. We run webinars probably every month, and we've currently got a bank of about 20 webinars there for you to go and view that we've recorded from previous times. They're short, about 30 minutes duration for the majority of them, and cover business topics, a range of business topics that you might be interested in. I wish you all the best with your training. Again, if there's any problems, please contact me and the team, and we'll help you out. Thanks a lot. All the best.